Hello, everyone, and welcome to Bin Right Sizing, a virtual coffee hour for EarthWISE, the sustainable business of Marion County. My name is Rachel Van Wert, and I am going to be your host today. I work with Marion County Environmental Services at the Public Works Campus in Silverton Road in Salem, and I am a waste reduction coordinator, and of course, the coordinator with the EarthWISE Sustainability Business Network. Here in Marion County, we are so very proud of the EarthWISE Network with over 200 members looking at ways to increase their sustainability, improve their ROI, and connect with the community. Today, we're going to jump into a really innovative concept that's been around for a while, and it's looking at how can your bins and your surface with your hauler be reviewed and looking for opportunities, not just to save money, but to also divert waste that should be recycled or put to another source out of our waste stream, whether it be landfill or waste to energy. Today, we are going to use an imaginary business to kind of do a hands-on project of looking at how to bin right size. And we're going to do a lot of math, and that can stretch our brains out a little bit, which is a great thing. But as we're going through this process and you're thinking, hey, I would love to try this at my business or bring this to my green team, please don't feel that you have to do the mad scribble for equations or making sure that you have the formulas correct. As you can see, you can email us at earthwise@co.marion.or.us and just say, hey, I would love the worksheets for bin right sizing. Everything that we talk about will be available to you. And if you are an EarthWISE member or you are currently working with us for EarthWISE certification and network membership, we can also provide some additional resources to help you actually physically do these audits and get your bins right sized. So we're going to jump into it. Follow along, please, if you are not live with us and you have additional questions, if you're requesting a sheet or just want some additional information, please, please, please feel free to reach out to us. So no pun intended, but let's dive in. So the first question is, what is right sizing? Why do we talk about it? Why is it important? When I go and I do walkthroughs with businesses here in Marion County, the bins are kind of this big mystery to a lot of people, unless you're the person often setting up the accounts or working directly with facilities. Many times when I ask questions about the bins, except for the fact that people can locate their closest trash bin and their closest recycling bin, there's not a lot of other knowledge. And if you're on a green team or you're helping in the office to look for reduction impacts, getting to know your bins is going to be really important. So easily, right size. This means to ensure that bin volume, the number of bins, and the collection pickup frequency for each material is accurate and appropriate. It's really easy to do once you understand the flow. It can save you money and it can help your hauler even by helping them increase the efficiency of routes. The other piece about bin right sizing that is so great is when you know what is going into your bins, that's the first step in keeping things out. So by auditing your bins and taking a look at what your service levels and volumes are, you can actually do reduction on the front end. How can we make sure we're having conversations about materials that could be reused, reduced upon purchasing, or going to a correct recycling facility before it goes kind of in that little black hole, that hiding spot, that bin that nobody takes a look at? why should we right size? Well, many businesses honestly never audit their waste service needs. Your facility pays for a service for each collection, whether it's full or not. In some areas, in some states, and in some jurisdictions, you will also pay for materials recycled incorrectly or contaminants in your recycling stream. We talk a lot about cross-contamination and willful recycling. Throwing away recyclables, or if they're viable in your area, compostables cost money. And it also is throwing away your space. It's throwing away the efficiency of a route truck coming and not picking up full bins each time. So what do we do about that, except kind of walk by the bin and pretend we don't notice it and hope that someone else will look at it? Well, the easiest way to do it is if you're the person in charge of this at your work site, getting ready to do an audit. If you're putting this to a green team or any collection of folks that work in the office who have an interest, you're going to have to gather a few things. We have to kind of have the information in the baseline before we jump into doing what our current level services, and then looking at where can we make those changes that are most impactful. So, you know, just the facts, only the facts, that's where we start. Obviously, sometimes if you go through a bin and you see things disposed of improperly, that might bring a little reaction in you, and that's good. And that's something that you can look at when you're talking about reduction efforts. But in the beginning, you don't want to do anything to kind of tamper with the current system. You just want to get the facts together. So the first thing is that we are going to look at what is it that we're doing in our partnership with our hauler. And here in Marion County, we have wonderful haulers. This is a great group. Their offices are friendly, their staff is knowledgeable. And if you don't have this information, if you are not sure what your rate sheet is or your current service level is, you can reach out to them and have a conversation. I also recommend every couple of years reaching out to them, jot down those questions that you have, check in. If you over a few months keep saying, oh, I wish I knew that, give them a call. They are going to be more than happy to talk to you about their service with them. You're going to identify and review the collection of your special materials. So if you have hazardous waste, if you have universal waste, electronic waste, if you have food, these are materials that might either be a service through your hauler or a service that you can contract out elsewhere. And you just kind of need to know what it is that you have so you know where it is it needs to go. And that's the next part. Look at your local recycling services, whether that be through the hauler or other contracted services. Check that cost information. And one of the things that folks often do not do is ask, are there rebates? Are there thresholds? Are there other things and incentives that can help you help your folks on site really dig down and look at this and practice good disposal techniques? Identify your schedule of operations. What does it look like? How does your building operate? You cannot base your level of service on what another site is doing, even if it's comparative in size or product or industry. You really have to understand what your operations are. And if you have a facilities manager, great. If you have a supervisory position that oversees this, is it janitorial? Is it maintenance? Reach out to them and just be like, hey, I am just really looking to check in and get this information because we want to do an audit. We want to start seeing where both our ROI and our environmental impact in a positive way can be. One of the questions I get a lot is sometimes folks do not even identify that there are many kinds of bins and dumpsters that a business can have. And so here are some of your options. We have the small wheeled totes or carts. A lot of times they're for smaller businesses. They look very similar to what we put out curbside every week. And these are our small wheeled carts. Next, we go up to dumpsters, and we can have dumpsters that are 2, 3, 4, or even 6 cubic yards. Our next one is our roll-off open-top containers, which are the 10 to 40 cubic yards. And our larger self-contained compactors, also 2 to 40 cubic yards. When you're looking at what you have, also look at, is that useful? Is it that you need something with a self-contained unit? Is it that the roll-off works? Is it that your business is really just great with your small wheeled cart system? Just kind of understand your options. And for folks that are wondering or are not familiar with it, a cubic yard is defined as the volume of a cube with the sides being 1 yard, 3 feet, 36 inches in length. And so a lot of times when you're talking about trash pickup in a commercial setting, we are talking about cubic yards. So when you're talking to a hauler or you're talking to your group, I would always suggest, if this is something that folks don't do every day, especially like on your green team, just give them that definition of what a cubic yard actually is. So it's a little bit of a mind wrap around, so people can start thinking of that in terms of volume. And again, as we go through this, there are going to be worksheets, folks. So please feel free, if you're seeing this and it's starting to spark interest, you don't have to worry about getting all of these fine-tuned notes down. We will make that available if you have an interest. The next piece that I always see when I do some walkthroughs with businesses, I go, where are your bins? And they'll show me the little office bin right there and the cubicles. And I said, what about the rest of your bins? Where are they? It's important, if you're the one working with audits and bin sizing, that you get very familiar with knowing what you have and where they're located. This is critical to really an efficient, continual management of service. This is not something that has to be done weekly or monthly, but even thinking of it as a tune-up once a year or every 1 to 3 years, if you're with EarthWISE certification, you could do a bin audit as you come up for your 4 to 5 year recert and just have that right there and walk us through it. It's a great practice. It's a great kind of mental exercise for your team, just remember to look at this. So if you have a large facility like here, it's really great to set up a spreadsheet, create a map that looks like a floor plan, note your location of bins, the materials that can be accepted in each bin, and the size and type of bin. Even with a small business, having something, a note in a small spreadsheet, or even if you wanted to draw a little rough floor plan and you have it by other documents tacked up on an information board, that's great. Find what works for you, but obviously the larger the facility, the more in depth you want to have this, so you don't forget a building or a location. So now we know where our bins are. That's great. What do we do with them? And sometimes when I say bin audit to folks, people get a little antsy, because the idea of maybe pawing through trash is off-putting. This is not what this audit is. This is not a take everything out and spread it on the ground kind of audit. This is a visual audit just to get some familiarity about what you have. So the best way to know your bins is to check them out, inspect them. When we do a waste audit for bin sizing, we are going to suggest 2 weeks on all bins. And making sure when you're looking at them, what their fullness is. We have a tracking sheet here. I apologize, the slide doesn't do it justice, but we also have that available for folks who would love to have a template for an audit. As you're doing your visual inspection every 2 days and making kind of this note, and as you see, it's full, quarter full, half full, empty, you're going to just do that visual estimation. And as you're doing it, start thinking about that. You know, are you seeing a pattern? Can there be bins that are smaller or picked up less? Are there bins that are always overflowing and need more service? Look at areas that might need a bin and don't have them, or look at bins that are being underutilized and see if they can be moved to other high traffic areas. Remember that this is your starting point. So after we do all the calculations with right sizing, you're going to make adjustments as needed. The goal really is to have your containers full at pickup. Definitely when the route comes around, that really is the goal. You're not wasting space, you're not wasting time, you're not wasting efficiency, sorry guys. And you know, we're not wasting fuel because we're not having people move on half empty loads. So what does this look like in practice? We've done this, we've taken our sheet and we've audited our bins for a couple weeks. And now we have all this data. What do we do with it? Because you can have all the data in the world. If you don't have a good use for it, it is just something that sits in a folder or in the cloud and takes up space. And it's something we want to actively use and we want to have flexibility with it. So today we're going to visit the ABC College cafeteria. They're open 5 days a week, 6 a.m. to 7 p.m., and they serve meals. They do not have any recyclable, compostable, or reusable dishware options. Most meals are served on paper plates with paper sleeves. Now, of course, as EarthWISE, we'd be having some conversations about reusables and how to correctly recycle other objects in the kitchen, but that is going to be another coffee hour. But what we know about this cafeteria is they have 3 bins, each 3 cubic yards, collected Monday through Friday. So having this information from them, what we are going to do is determine the current volume and cost of service per month. We're going to estimate the current volume of waste by type based on our visual inspection. Remember, there's no need for anybody to be crawling in bins. We're going to explore our options. How can we look at service levels and saving? And we're going to do a comparison between the proposed level of service against our current level of service. And if this is something that you're bringing to a supervisor or a board or a team, this comparison is going to probably be the most telling as far as ROI. So we never really want to skip this step. It can sometimes feel like it's easy to skip this step, but when you're talking about how do you achieve that buy-in from a larger group, the ROI is a very black and white impactful statement. So before we kind of jump into the determining current volume, let's talk about timing really quick as we start our audit. When you get ready to do your audit and you have your team set, you need to make sure that you are using your current regular times. Having an audit while a plant is on shutdown, or having an audit while there are rush orders or major events does not really give you an accurate picture. So what you're going to look at when you do your timing is, you know, what are the days and times of your operation? Are you day versus night? Are you 24/7? Where is the time where you can inspect the bins where they are technically done for the day? And I'm sorry, you can't see my air quotes on that, but it's that last available window of when service can happen, when people can put the bins out and ready to go. Do you have heavy nights or weekends? Do you host events that are regular and not one-offs? All of these things you need to kind of make sure you're doing in your timing, because you want to audit your bins on your most regular cycle of operations. That's really going to make sure you're not skewing your data too much. So the first step in bin right sizing is really exactly this. We're going to determine our current volume of service per month. The reason we do this is we want to know what our current volume can be reduced to by using some reduction techniques. So we're going to start in your container volume in cubic yards. Your total container volume is the total number of bins times the bin size in cubic yards. So as you can see in this case, 3 bins by 3 cubic yards equals 9 cubic yards for the collection of each service. Once we have that number, then we're going to look at our pickups per month. So the total of number of pickups is equal to the number of pickups per week. Oftentimes in these calculations, people use 4.33. It's a more accurate calculation of weeks in a month. And so here we go. We have 5 days a week times 4.33, and we get 21.65 collection days each month. Now that we have that information, we now can go and look at what our true volume of service is per month. So we go to our total container volume. We have 9 cubic yards, picked up 21.65 days. So the current volume of service is 194.85 cubic yards picked up monthly. We're going to round that as we do our math to 195. Now, this is a chart that's kind of just a universal one. This is not our Marion County one. Again, this is as you get ready to do this process, check in with your hauler and get your current service rates. But what you do is you take your rate per bin service, the total of number of bins, and that's going to get your cost of service per month. So in this case, with our ABC facility, the current cost of service is $4,210.92. And that is for the bins as is. We have that basic information, great. Now we're gonna take our audit information and look at how it stacks up against our proposed cost of service. So first thing in this process is you're looking at your estimated current volume of waste by type. Again, reminder, this is not people in depth with garbage spread out on a tarp, that is a materials management audit. We are just looking for bin fullness. So if you're always starting with the assumption that a bin should be 100% full, and then look at your bins, bin one is filled to the top, it's 100% full. And by a quick look into the bin, we are seeing it's 25% trash, 75% cardboard. Bin two looks about halfway full, it's 100% cardboard. Bin three, we come around the corner, we check that out, it is only a quarter full, and that is 100% trash. So let's estimate the current volume of waste by type. This is where you are doing a little more than estimating, but not quite a deep dive in. You're really looking at what is the trash bag and what is the other things in the trash in terms of materials. Cafeteria ABC, we have two options in our trash. We are seeing bags of trash and we are seeing cardboard. So if we use our cardboard here, you will see bin size one is 3 cubic yards. It's 100% full. It's 25% trash and 75% cardboard. So looking at our percentage of cardboard, for example, we would take our cardboard, multiply it by 3 cubic yards by 0.1 by 0.75, and that equals 2.25 cubic yards. Now that we know what that waste is for that bin, we would do it as you see for all three of our bins. So we have bin one, 2.25 cubic yards of cardboard, bin two, 1.5 cubic yards of cardboard, and bin three, 0% cardboard. What we are going to do is add our percentage of cardboard. So our 2.25 plus 1.5 plus 0 gives us 3.75. To look at the volume generated monthly, we would look at how many days of the week we have pickup on service, which is 5. And then which gives us our 18.75. And then we are going to multiply that by weeks per day, which is the 4.33. So what we can estimate for the total volume of cardboard is 8.2 cubic yards per month generated from these bins. And if you do the same thing with our waste, we see that we have our 32.5 cubic yards of waste generated per month that is not cardboard. Now we have these numbers. Now we know how much we're currently paying for our trash service as is. We have made no changes to it. We know the volume of trash and we know the volume of cardboard that we saw in that bin that's coming out each month. As we go through that, we can then start talking about the reduction factor. The reduction factor is looking at those things that can either be reduced upstream, so they're being purchased, used, reused, repaired in any way that they're not winding up in the bin. Is there room for that? Reduction factor is also what is going in the bin that shouldn't. Is it more appropriate for a recycling program, either through a hauler or through another contracted individual? If you're in an area that it applies, is there some compostable wear to that? Each reduction factor is going to be based on how your business operates. And sometimes it's just the low hanging fruit. You don't have to start with everything happening at once. You don't have to have 17 programs that come out of the bin audit. you can have one. And for cafeteria ABC, we are going over and looking at this low-hanging fruit, that cardboard that wasn't even flattened. It was just put in the trash unflattened. So we are going to say, to our group, we're looking for 50% reduction of cardboard in our bins by people flattening it and putting it into the recyclable materials instead of into our waste bins. Each reduction factor is going to look different on how your business has the results of this audit, but it's a great way to get talking about what is going in there, why is it going in there, and should it be in there? And that should be, like you said, again, something that happens on a regular basis, once a year, once every couple of years, if you're doing EarthWISE recertification. It's just a great way to continually spot check, both for environmental impact and ROI. And as we look at this, you guys will see why that difference is so important. So when we looked at the reduction, we are going to assume that we want a 50% reduction for cardboard. So we're going to explore kind of the improved service level. So for our cardboard, we know that it's 81.2 cubic yards. Our reduction factor is 50% or 0.5. So our weekly reduction goal is our monthly cubic yards, the 81.2 times our reduction factor, which is 0.5, divided by our monthly 4.33. And that gives us 9.4 cubic yards per week. That is our new option for service level. When we take those numbers and we look at the optimal bin size, we see that both our trash and our cardboard, by improving our service levels, can reduce the amount of pickups. We were spending an awful lot of time picking up product that should not have been in, and the materials weren't even handled in a correct fashion. So, you know, and then you look at the bin size, the optional bin size or the optimal bin size. A 4 cubic yard bin picked up 2 times a week would have been the optimal volume and level of service for cardboard. However, sometimes optimal does not happen right away. Sometimes there is a comfort and security factor in folks not feeling like all of the bins have gone and we're shortchanging ourselves. And it is a good practice to, especially when you're getting people into new habits, focuses and behaviors, it is good practice to build in a buffer to avoid overflowing bins, because having those overflowing bins will really have folks say, this program isn't working, this challenge isn't working. We now have, you know, cardboard overflowing or the trash is peeking out. So sometimes it is better to make sure that you have a slight buffer in your improved service levels, because you want the environmental impact, but you also need your workplace buy-in. And so for people, perception is sometimes part of the change of behavior. Looking at proposed service levels, this is why, as I'm not a math fan, I always kid that I always said I would never use all this math again, and here I am using all this math again. But when we talk about ROI, the savings alone are impactful enough to sometimes bring people who may be on the fence about the environmental change, who may feel like it could be hard to change a process or a program. But when you look at ROI and that what is then built back into your business with the added sustainability impact. It makes a really good argument, and it makes a universal argument for management teams, for green teams, for your maintenance folks, all of those people who really kind of need to sometimes see a bottom line. So let's take a look at this. And this is based on, again, our cost for service for this exercise. You, of course, would know this information after chatting with your hauler and plugging in your correct rate of service for all of the things collected on a route with them. So currently, just doing what we do, people tossing things in, not having some awareness or conversations about what belongs where. The current level of service is 195 cubic yards a month of trash. Now, could we get that down depending on what's in the trash? Of course, maybe that's the next step. But we're going to start with what was most obvious, at least in this bin audit, the one that we can do the quick impact and build on. And I would recommend that for anyone. Find the lowest hanging fruit, impact that change, and then go back and dig deeper and look at how can we even fine tune this even more. So when we then look at removing the cardboard, our proposed level of service for trash is the 32.5 cubic yards a month. So how does that impact the bottom line, the bill? So the cost for service currently, ABC Cafeteria, we're paying to throw out a recyclable material, and we are paying at quite a heavy rate. The current service is $4,210 a month. The proposed service is $842 a month. We are going with that ABC Cafeteria is in an area where both bins are included in service and that there is not an additional charge for recyclable materials, or that they are using a bailing contract service where they're actually obtaining some information back. So for our current recycling of cardboard, our proposed recycling is the 81.2 cubic yards a month. The cost reduction is $3,368.73 a year. So over 30,000 a year in trash savings at this cafeteria. And the other piece of this that is incredibly promising to have the conversation about is 81.2 cubic yards of cardboard a month are being diverted out of the waste stream and into their correct collection stream, which is a recycling stream. So 81 cubic yards a month of product coming out of the landfill or waste to energy. That is significant sustainability impact with very little policy change and very doable employee change. Cardboard gets broken down, cardboard goes into this correct container, that container has signs, there's a memo, we encourage people to do it. And the impact is in the pocketbook and in the planet. And also for your morale of people who work there, knowing that a slight behavior change can make a difference. I hope folks are thinking about this. I hope folks are curious about this, about what is happening in your trash. What is it that your business could do to have an ROI and have some additional sustainability? What habits can we create? How can we talk about this? And that really is the bigger goal of bin right sizing, of course, it is to get those bins full and full correctly to work efficiently with your hauler. But the next piece of that is having these simple behaviors that move the needle for diversion at your work site. So next steps, I always tell people, your next steps really should be, how do we have excitement? How do we have conversation? And how do we keep this going? Next steps I would propose for folks, if this is something that you want to do, please send me an email. We will get you all of these worksheets, from doing your checklist to your first bin visual audits to the little fill-in sheet for all the math where you're plugging your numbers in. It has the formula for you. Taking that information and calling your hauler and saying, hey, I'd love to have a checkup because we just noticed X. Get your service sized, share your savings, and by sharing your savings, start having those internal conversations about, now that we've taken X out, maybe it is time to go do that deeper waste audit where we pull a bag and see what is in there and how can we source reduce, how can we reuse, how can we repair. All of those things are really going to keep your employees engaged. It's going to keep your community engaged when people know that this business is not just keeping an eye on the bottom line, but using the triple bottom line, people, planet, profits. It all works together to create a system where our communities are well and sustainable. Also, please reach out to me if you take the worksheets and you have questions, or you're a little stuck, or you'd like more information. Again, I have the email where you can request your worksheet on bin sizing. It will give you everything you need, like I said, from the setup to the formula. For current local rates, or what your rate is with your hauler, please contact your hauler. And then to learn more about commercial waste, or to grab a really great phone app that's going to let you track your home pickups and has a waste wizard for resources of where things can go outside your blue bin, you're going to go to mrtrashrecycles.com, and that is with the Mid Valley Garbage and Recycling Association, which is our Marion County Association of all of our haulers. We want to thank the Mid Valley Garbage and Recycling Association for a great partnership with us forever, and a great partnership for our businesses and our community. You can find more about Mid Valley Garbage and Recycling Association on their website, which is above. They also have a Facebook page. And as I said at the beginning of our time together, you can also go to mcrecycles.net for information on waste reduction, our transfer stations, garbage pickup, household hazardous waste, and other items that are from water quality to where can I recycle an odd item. Plus, you can get in touch with the EarthWISE program via that site as well. Thank you so much for our time together. I hope this has got your brain spinning a little bit and thinking about how this could be a project, how you could connect with us, and how we could help you work on improving your triple bottom line. For those of you who requested a link, we'll be sending that out for anyone who again joined us either through our virtual events page or found us on YouTube or our Facebook page. Thank you for spending the time with us. I hope to connect with all of you. I hope that this starts projects that intrigue you and are good for your business. Until I can see you in person, I've had a lovely time talking with you all. And until we can meet in person, I hope you stay well. Have a great day, everyone.